Welcome back from that short break. You're still watching PM Live, and I am Amelia Martha Nachdimbo. Now, seven rival leaders of Tekwaro Lango, who were arrested last week and detained at Lira Central Police Station, have been granted state bond following instructions from the so-called above. The leaders have organized elections to replace the sitting paramount chief, Yosam Odurebi, who has been in power since December 1st, 2005. Our reporter has the details.
You can do it outside.
The leaders, who compose of members of the Electoral Commission, are Vincent Oling, the chairperson, Tom Anang Odur, a former member of parliament for Maruzi, Reverend Martin Odongo, a clerk to council, Tekwaro Lango, Lucy Owino, and ex-RDC Joan Pakoto, who were arrested on Friday, while retired Colonel Tony Otoa was arrested the following day. Joan Pakoto fainted in the cell moments after she was booked in and was released on police bond to be rushed for treatment. Oling and a blind man Otoa were also given state bond, and both were tasked to report to Lira Central Police Station every morning, where they would spend the whole day. Before being granted state bond on Monday evening, the leaders, who were charged with unlawful assembly, and for Oling, in addition, uttering a false document, had another charge of promoting war on chiefs, contrary to Section 27 of the Penal Code Act, preferred against them.
There's that in terms of people come from outside. So we're fought. Then to bump him and say, unlawful assembly is quite upset in my own house, my own sitting room. So I saw there must be some other reason behind.
We have already our structure in existence. Elections took place. Declarations were made. Regrettably, some of the commissioners were in detention. They could not attend. But those who were there attended, and it went out very successfully.
The resident state attorney, Gloria Akelo, said the file is being taken to Kampala for the attention of the Director of Public Prosecution, since it's a sensitive matter. Relatives of the leaders and their subjects thronged the police to commiserate with them.
Our highly respected elder in my clan of Mua Tiratok has been here, and the gentleman is blind. Is being paraded here every day, and that one causes a bit of anxiety among the clan members. So I think if this one continues, they will be in a long way trying to promote hatred among the different clans in now. And I am begging them kindly to leave land on. Let the elders do whatever they think is good for this region.
The suspects will report on police on Friday to answer the bond. The case is registered under CRB 409/2017. Report filed by Hudson Apunyo for Urban Television.
Now, Urban Television drama series Coffee Shop has awarded one lucky winner, Brandon Chimuli, as a way of appreciating and bringing viewers closer to the show. Now, Chimuli becomes the first person to be rewarded, and this comes after he engaged the cast most on social media using the hashtag Coffee Shop UG. We have more.
The winner got an opportunity to interact with the cast, lunch and photo opportunity, bag and t-shirt of Urban Television, among many others. The idea was the winner to have a Valentine's treat with the cast.
There was a tweet exchange with the cast. So all we did was tweet, and we're talking about love and relationships. You know, it's February, the month of love. So that is what we are doing. We are tweeting about love. I was asking them questions. I was asking Lisa questions. Yeah, basically.
They also took him through the process of how the series are produced, which involves a number of stages from an initial story, idea or directive, through screenwriting, casting, shooting, sound recording and production, editing and screening, the finished product before an audience that may result in a film release and exhibition.
It's the first time that Brandon came through, and it was really amazing. Definitely, he got a cup of coffee, he got to engage with everyone on a personal basis. We even got to know each other even more, not just like a fan, but like probably even we can be even more friends or even work together, because he's actually an actor. Yeah, he's not just a fan, but he's an actor, so actually he's feeling like he's in this kind of dream, so which I think for him was really big. So it's just that we need them to come, have fun with us, talk to us, let's get to know them, let them get to know us. Even after set, even after work, we can still meet up anywhere.
It's not awarding viewers per se, we're just creating an opportunity, as always, to keep interacting with Urban TV viewers. As Vision Group, it's a norm always to try and deliver memorable experience to our wonderful customers.
Coffee Shop is an Urban Television series that runs from Monday to Wednesday at 9:30 p.m. The series is about gossip, drama, entertainment, and relationship. I'm Dennis Wanyala, reporting for Urban Television.
Keep watching, keep engaging. You too could get lucky. Today is Brandon Chimuli. Now, business communities and farmers in Barra have accused Bank of Uganda of not putting up stringent measures to deter commercial banks from charging high interest rates. They feel exploited and cheated by commercial banks, some of which are charging over 26% in interest. But as we report, Bank of Uganda insists that this is a liberal economy and prices are determined by forces of demand and supply.
As it has been the public outcry across the country, residents of Mbarara too feel betrayed and cheated by commercial banks. The demand that the central bank categorically explains why rates remain high in Uganda, yet in Kenya the government was able to set a cut under which all banks charge.
We are down and we want to be lifted. The Bank of Uganda is an agent of the government trying to give us that. Now, if you cannot put these banks, if you cannot direct these banks, you direct them to not to cheat us, not to exploit us, but take us to where the government wants us to go, we shall be making a mistake.
Farmers here argue that the relevancy of applying for an agricultural loan is yet to be seen, as the interest remains high, yet the sector employs over 70% of the locals. These cite instances where agriculture loans are now at 26% from 12%. But the central bank, in its response, insists that they cannot regulate interest rates charged by commercial banks.
Why don't we have very little money amongst ourselves? If I get any small loan from my commercial bank, they are giving it at 26% per annum, 28. You are not, there is a freedom, free market. Now what's your logic, logically? Okay. What is it you are after?
We are trying to eat about 5 bags in one store. We may be wanting to encourage investment, but in so doing, we also want to encourage savings. There's no way you're going to invest if you are not saving something for the future. You may invest today and eat up everything. So by going through the commercial bank, you'll open an account.
They have also asked the central bank to educate them on electronic money transfers to avoid being cheated.
We are an eye opener to us. There is what we call electronic transfer of money. Why did it come? If you are there, why don't you take a big observation and help the man, kind of a farmer, mine kind of a teacher, mine kind of a lawyer, so that you come directly to him.
The issue of interest rates is one that might be far from over, although the question then remains, what will happen to the business community who are already struggling and closing shop due to high taxes and rent? Report by Simon Okitela and Halson Kagure for Urban Television.
Well, Valentine's Day is not yet out of our minds completely, and usually it's known as a dress for a black and red dress code. However, it seems that for most Ugandans, the day was celebrated without the themed dress code or the colors. And also yesterday, one Ugandan 31-year-old Paul Kirunji launched an application that connects single people to their future loved ones.
Just when you're looking at someone's picture, you don't like them, you just swipe that. You just swipe left. You don't like them. But if you like them and you're interested, you can come here on I it means information, and read about them. If you like what they are, about them, then you can swipe them right. Now when you swipe right, and they also swipe you right, then the app automatically matches you people, and it will send notification to both of you that, hey, you've been matched with someone. You can see it yourself if you've been swiping, and then you can instantly start messaging each other.
I think Valentine's Day is not about... It's not about a seasonal kind of thing that comes and goes. Love should be celebrated every day. It should be Valentine's every day. Every day, not just one day, 14th, and then we wear a red and black and everything. No. You can wear anything you like as long as love is in you.
And that was how Valentine's Day went for those. Well, for me here, I had a wish, and I must say my camera person brought me flowers behind the scenes. Now let's have a recap of our main stories today. Besigye files petition protesting appearing in court for his treason case mention. Five arrested over car and border robberies in Iganga district. Two Chinese nationals killed in Makerere Chikoni here in Kampala. And that's it for now. Thank you so much for your company. But PM Live continues to bring you current affairs. Be sure to catch our news wrap at 4 p.m. And also do not miss our subsequent news bulletin at 8 p.m. Have a blessed afternoon.
On Berlin's